Hello, hi everyone. My name is Sile. My surname is Hacı Hanefioğlu, but never mind about it. It's one of the longest words in Turkish, probably. Today I'm here to be talking about some methodologies that we used in neuroscience tools. I'm coming from Turkey, Istanbul. Maybe you've heard about the brand Turkcell. There's Turkcell Europe, actually. It's in Germany called as Turkcell Europe. Turkcell is one of the biggest telecommunications companies in Europe. We are active in 9 countries with more than 50 million customers all over the world. And I'm in the marketing research team of Turkcell. Today, I'm going to be talking about an ad research that we conducted last year. Our communications team approached us with a question about using sign language in TV ads. What I'm trying to tell about sign language is the woman you see on the right-hand side of the screen. During the ad, there's a narrator at the right bottom side, and it explains for deaf people what the ad is about. And we conducted the research for both versions of the ad. One original one with no sign language, and the other one was the the one with the sign language was the one with the narrator, actually. We could have used some conventional techniques, like just asking people whether they like the ad or not, they understood the ad or not, but what we tried to understand was, the question was, does the narrator distract the attention of the audience? Because when you concentrate on that narrator, you feel like everybody is just looking at the narrator. They are just trying to understand which sign represents which word in Turkish. You try to read their lips. You feel like it's something very important and exciting, so nobody will be watching the rest of the ad. So they were suspicious whether that was causing distraction or not. Rather than using conventional techniques, we created a hybrid methodology, a combination of EEG and eye tracking. Do you know what EEG is? Probably you've heard about it. It means electrocephalography. Actually, this is the second longest word, probably after my surname. But today I'm going to be just saying EEG, that's the shortcut of this word. And it's something like you put a cap at the head of the audience and you just make them watch the ad on the computer. There are like spots at the head, and that cap receives the brain signals of the respondent and records the trend of those signals, and with the computer, the moderator do the statistical results at the end. So there's nothing the respondent has to do. They are just putting the cap on and watching the ad and track the brain signals. The scores that we can track with the EEG methodology is engagement, excitement, and frustration scores. Engagement scores shows whether the scenes that they are watching are boring or catchy. So if you have a low engagement score, it means that they are not engaged, they are getting bored, and they just want the scene, the ad, to end. Excitement shows whether the scenes that they are seeing or the thing that they are seeing on the screen are exciting or calming. Physically, that is shown as heartbeat, sweating, your pupils getting bigger. That shows that a person is getting excited. And lastly, the frustration scores shows whether the scene or the thing that they are seeing on the screen are easy to understand, or is it complicated? They are spending some time trying to understand what the thing is talking about. When you have an ad or a visual, you want it to have a high engagement high excitement score because you want to be connected, and you want to have a low frustration score because you don't want to people get distracted or complicated. Eye tracking is, as some other researchers showed today, it's just following the eye movements, and it shows on the screen where that respondent looks at and how long they look at, actually. As the dots get redder and bigger, it shows that lots of people are looking at it at that place, and they are spending more time at that part of the screen. So we combine those two methodologies because we want to know where people are looking during the scenes, because if they are looking at the narrator or not. And on the other hand, we want to understand whether they are getting distracted with that narrator. Are they understanding the ad? Are they still engaged to the ad? So we combined those two methodologies. This is the original version of the ad, the one without the narrator. If you could just play the video. I know none of you speaks Turkish or understands Turkish, so I'm just going to show the scenes. This is the original ad, the original version. On the left-hand side of the screen, you see the heat map, the eye tracking part of the study. You can see the red dots getting bigger and moving around the screen. That shows normally where people are concentrating during the ad itself. And you can see that generally it's on the main person, the cast, and they are trying to reach their eyes, etc. And on the right-hand side of the screen, you can see the EEG scores, engagement, excitement, and frustration scores. I don't know if it's clear for you. The blue one is the engagement, red one is the excitement, and the yellow one is the frustration score. Now, we have the scores of the original ad for those 24 people. Then, we did the same thing for the version with the sign language. You see there is a woman narrator there using the sign language. If you could again play the video. This is exactly the same video. The only difference is the narration on the right-hand side. Again, you can see the heat map of the video, and you can see the EEG scores, EEG trends of the same scene. Receiving all the data for the both versions, at the end, we compared the results, overall results for the heat maps, the eye tracking part, and the EEG scores, average EEG scores, and then we decided whether that narrator was a distraction or not. I'm not gonna make you watch the movie all over again. So, if you take a look at the results of the EEG tests, I'm just showing the average scores for both versions. The blue one is the engagement score. Huh? This SL stands for the one with the sign language. ORG stands for the original version. So we are comparing the EEG scores for the both versions. As you can see, the engagement scores are exactly the same. So that shows that the narrator does not distract the attention of the respondents, actually. That's good news. If you take a look at the excitement scores, the average excitement scores, we see that there's a slight difference between, even though it's not a significantly high difference, there's a slight difference between the excitement score, but luckily, the one with the sign language has a higher excitement score. So this is even better news, because we were going to decide whether we should use the original one or the one with the narrator. So the one with the sign language seems better. If we take a look at the frustration score, as I mentioned before, we want to have a lower frustration score in a TV ad because we don't want them to get bored or distracted or want to turn off the TV while watching the ad. So the frustration score are lower than the overall study average for the both versions. This is good news, and there is not a difference between the original one and the one with the sign language. That's even better. When we take a look at the overall eye tracking comparison scores, you cannot see the whole ad. I'm not going to show you the whole ad again, make you watch the whole versions again. But when we compare the EEG, the eye tracking scores, the heat map for the both versions, we again realize that that narrator is not taking the attention of the respondent as much as we thought, because we felt like everybody is just looking at the narrator and not watching the ad. That was not the case. I'm going to give you the numbers now. So one of the learnings that we get from this study was the narrator was noticed within the 1.5 seconds of the ad, and they focus on the sign language only for 0.3 seconds on average. So they are not, the respondents are not really distracted with that narrator. They are just gazing at the narrator time to time. They are not continuously watching and trying to understand the sign language as we expected. And only 8% of the total gazes were on the narrator. So the rest of the gazes were on the rest of the screen. So that solves our problem, actually. Some other key takeouts that we had from the study was the sign language is because there were some key notes that we have to get during the production time of the ad. If we try to shoot another ad with sign language, there are some things that we have to keep in mind for the future. The sign language, the narrator is watched even more during the scenes which are contrast with the background. What I'm trying to mean is when the background is white and the narrator is dressed in red or black, it takes the attention of the audience because they want to, since the contrast is high, they want to look at the audience even more than they used to. And another thing is, if the scene on, at that moment is something very complex or includes so much action, wording, pop-ups, etc., an additional complex thing is another narrator. I mean, the narrator being there causes another confusion. So we have to be, if we are going to use narration in TV ads, we have to take care of it. I mean, we have to keep in mind that the scenes should not be complex when there is also a narrator on the screen. It should be a slow-moving ad, actually. And at the end of the screen, maybe you saw that there was a Turkcell logo, the pack shot, at the end of the ad. The longer the pack shot stays on the screen, the tendency of focusing on the sign language increases, because a pack shot is a still screen. There's nothing moving and there's nothing going on the screen. So people tend to look at the narrator even more when everything is still. And we also had a question about the subtitles. Maybe you noticed that there was a continuous subtitle at the bottom of the ad. And that's because of the legal issues. We have to be talking about everything while people are watching the ad. Luckily, almost no time is spent focusing on the subtitles for both versions. So that's safe for us as well, because the audience spends only 1% of the ad checking the subtitles. That's good for us. And for the both versions, only a few participants with an average of 0.05 or 0.1 seconds spent focusing on the subtitles, which is also good news. By the way, after the tests, after the EEG and eye tracking tests, we had interviews with the respondents, in-depth interviews. Our moderator had an interview with the respondents, with those 24 people. And we realized that even though our aim was only to choose which version of the ad to shoot or to decide, I mean, if we could use the narrator or not, that was the question, actually. But during those interviews, we realized that Using a narrator, using a sign language in TV ads, people were very excited about this idea. I mean, people felt that's what Turkcell should do. That's how a leader company should act. Everybody should be using sign language. All the brands should be embracing all types of people. I mean, it somehow started to be a social responsibility company. So we realized that that would also had emotional benefits for the brand, and we came up with an idea of using sign language in all our ads, actually, not just one. So in 2016, we used sign language narration in all our TV ads. That should be like more than 70 ads or something. And that turned out to be a great idea, because at the end of the year, there was a significant increase in our brand image attributes. And also social media was very positive about it. And actually, we became a love mark by the end of the year, and our brand image KPIs, such as brand that I love, brand that understands everyone, brand that embraces everyone, criterias increased significantly after those ads. That's all I'm going to be talking about, our neuroscience tools. But if you have any questions, I think we should have time. Much time. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Firstly, do we have any questions from the room? We certainly have a few on Slido. Okay, I'll jump straight to one of the top ones on Slido. It's essentially, for this particular piece of research, why did you choose to go down the EEG and eye tracking route as opposed to any traditional method?
Because when you ask someone whether they liked it, they like to have a... They would like to prefer or watch a TV ad with sign language. When you ask this question conventionally, nobody would say no, because they would all say, yeah, sure, everybody should be using it. Of course, you should put it on. But maybe deep inside, that may not be the truth, because, okay, I know it's a good idea to use that, but still, we are doing a campaign here. We are trying to sell something here. So people should not be distracted by that. Only this is for some deaf people. I mean, not everybody else should be looking and concentrating on the narrator. So if you ask this question explicitly, we thought that the results would not be fair, actually.
And did you do a side-by-side comparison to determine that, or have you done that in a previous study?
Yeah, that was a learning from previous studies.
Right. Okay, brilliant. That's great. Again, we have so many different questions in here. I propose that we don't go through them now, but we'll send them to you.
Of course.
And we'll get some written feedback on them. Sure. The reason I say that, some of them I don't understand. They're very
so
specific and very scientific.
Okay.
So at that point, I'll say a big thank you.
Thank you.
Well done.